Annandag jul 2004 hände det ofattbara som kom att förändra hennes liv för alltid. Hon hade rest till Thailand för att fira jul med sin familj. Men semesterparadiset Khao Lak förvandlades till ett helvete. Och Malin förlorade 3 av sina 5 barn i den fruktansvärda flodvåg som kostade 220 000 människor livet. Hon ska få träffa vårt medium Terry Evans och förhoppningen är att han ska kunna få kontakt med något av hennes döda barn. Men det finns inga garantier för att han lyckas med det. Och aldrig tidigare har väl jag hoppat så hårt att en inspelning som vi gör med okända ska gå bra.
Vad har du för förväntningar inför mötet med Terry?
Jag hoppas ju att få träffa mina 3 barn. Vibeke, Filip och Emma.
Kommer du bli hemskt besviken om det inte lyckas?
Det är klart att jag blev besviken, men samtidigt så vet jag ju att det finns en möjlighet att de inte har tid, kanske.
Before I begin, I'll explain to you a little bit about how I work with the spirit contacts. They decide what they're going to talk to you about today. They decide who it will be that tries to make contact with you. And my job is just to be used, or allow myself to be used, as a neutral link between their world and the here and now.
Okay.
So let's see what's going to happen here,
yeah.
Shall we? Well, as I come with you, as I start making contact and the spirits are coming through, I have 2 main contacts here. One's a woman.
Okay.
I don't know if she's a mother or a grandmother yet, but she's there. And she's very strong.
Okay.
But she's quite a happy lady. She's looking happy. She's wearing glasses. And she's just sitting there looking and looking at you. And she's been looking at you for quite some time. Do you want to start?
Yeah.
And she's delighted to be here today. Because then I have a man here. He's not an old man. He's not an old man.
Okay.
I don't know if he's close to you. He was close to you. And he's quite a good-looking guy. You know, he's sort of... When he's coming close to me, he's got a beautiful smile, this guy. He's got such a wonderful smile.
Yeah, I know him.
But he was intelligent. He was smart. He knew what he wanted in life. He didn't waste time. Do you understand this? He was once he made up his mind he wanted something, it was almost impossible to stop him. It's almost, as he talks to me, it's almost, you know when you're really excited and you have 1,000 things to say and you're trying to say them all at once, okay? But he's going to say this to you. I loved you then. I loved you now. That love must will never go. Do you understand?
Yeah, I understand.
But now one of the reasons he's coming back, he's saying to you, it is time for you to let me go. Not that he disappears forever, not that he doesn't want to come back and visit you, but he means it like this. He came back because he was aware of your grief. Shorter.
Mm-hmm.
He's been visiting your home, as you know, and doesn't think much of the curtains that you're thinking of putting up or changing.
That's not true, because I don't have any curtains.
But,
and I haven't think about putting...
That's the joke he's making.
Okay.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
You know, before this man passed, he really wasn't sure. In the last, I'm going to say it to you like this, in the last moments, minutes or seconds of his life, he didn't know what was happening. He didn't know.
No. I know that.
He didn't know. It was so, it just total confusion. It was like, and as he comes closer to me, you know, I'm gasping for breath. I'm choking. Do you understand me?
Yes, I understand.
I'm choking.
Yeah.
And I, as I'm choking and I can't take air, I don't know if there's water around me, but I can't breathe. I'm choking. And these, as he comes to me today, as he comes close to me, he's remembering the conditions by which he passed, the conditions that caused his passing over into spirit. He's still confused. There's a lot of confusion here, but... And I don't know. Well, I'm just going to do something really strange. Look, I take out this flower... I give it to you, and he's saying, give this to Mama.
Okay.
Tell Mama I'm okay.
Okay.
You must look alike, you two guys, you and he.
Oh, okay. Yes?
You look alike. I don't know if you're twins, but you look alike. When he makes a joke, he's better looking than you.
He is. He sure is. Yeah.
I don't know what this means. He's... Did he ever borrow money off of you?
Not that much.
But he's joking, it's a joke. He's saying, can I pay you back? Can I pay you back? Can I pay you back? It's a joke.
Yeah, yeah.
It's almost like before he passed, he owed you some money or he owed you something.
Yeah, it was very little.
Okay.
Just but small.
But it's like... As he talks about this money, it's just his little way of giving you even more proof. Do you understand?
Yeah.
I'm having trouble with him, actually, because he's so excited. He's so happy that he's getting through. Do you understand?
Yeah, I do.
He's saying, I was so vulnerable. I didn't know what to do and I didn't know how to be, but every time there was you.
Yeah.
You were my warrior, you were my protector. And that's why, and he kind of skips, he almost becomes like a little boy sometimes. Do you understand?
Yes, I really do.
He's like a little boy, sometimes like a little boy in a man's body almost.
Mm.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
And he was a little boy. But. He tells me you protected him for almost all his life.
Yeah, I did.
You
yes.
protected him. You was almost like his second mama, in one respect. You wasn't his mama, but you played the role of guardian. You played the role of protector, and you wouldn't let anybody or anything come near him. This kind of man connected you. This man's
yes.
like a brother almost. He's very close.
He's more than a brother.
Okay.
Mm.
But he's
can I...
No, no, don't tell me. No. I've got to let him talk to you. I've got to let him talk to you in his way. Okay? But it's like, oof. He wants to say, I didn't feel any pain. I didn't feel any pain, but everything around me went black.
Yes, I do.
Everything around me went black, and then wherever he was laying, or whatever happened, I don't know if it was you or someone was trying to shake him, or someone was trying to bring him back.
Really?
Someone was trying to bring him back, but they couldn't bring him back. Do you understand? I don't know what this means, but I'm choking. Oh, he's calming down a bit, but I. He's like a balloon. He's bouncing. He's playing. It's like, okay, as he's coming back, okay. Were you emotionally involved with this man or like in a partnership with him?
No partnership, no.
But emotionally involved?
Yes, really, really deep.
Yeah.
Yes.
And because I get what I keep getting with this is love. Do you understand?
Yes.
Love. And it's the love between, it's almost like the love, it feels like the love between a man and a woman. But it, do you understand this?
Yes, really.
Okay. But it's like his ending was so dramatic.
Yes, he did.
Would you understand that he was either hit by something or something happened so quickly that it put his body into shock?
Yes.
I tell you the feeling he's giving me. I want to be sick.
Really?
I want to be sick. I want to throw up. Do you understand this?
Yeah.
And if I could throw up, I could have got that substance out of my body or whatever it was. Do you understand? It's like, he was in shock. And that's why he didn't, but whatever hit him or whatever happened, happened so quickly. And he's going to say this again. I didn't see it coming. Do you understand?
Yes, I do.
It's like, watch. Like
yes,
that.
I know.
One moment he was fine, and then he was bang.
Yes.
He was hit. And he, and whatever happened to him, it's like, I'm feeling that my body, it always gives me a feeling of being crushed or being held so tight, I can't breathe.
I know, exactly.
You understand?
Yes, I do.
My lungs are collapsing. You understand?
Yes.
My lung and all this part of my torso is collapsing, and it's just, it's just stopped working.
Yes, I know.
But he does this. He's going to say this. Do you want to drink a beer with me?
No, I don't. I don't like beer.
Did you understand?
Yes.
He just says, do you want to drink a beer with me? And he laughs. But he's going to pick up a glass. Watch what he's doing. And he's going to take that glass of beer away. He's going to put it there, and he's going to say to you, I don't drink beer anymore. I've stopped. Do you understand? Mm-hmm. I've stopped. I don't need to anymore. I'm free from that beer.
Philip drack knappt alkohol överhuvudtaget, och Terry har inte fått kontakt med någon av döttrarna. Inte heller har han sagt att det är Malins son han kommunicerar med. Därför bestämmer vi oss för att pröva något vi aldrig tidigare provat. Vi ber Malin ta fram de tre foton hon har med sig.
These are the same person.
It's not the same person.
No.
No.
No. There's three people.
Yes.
I think I know what's happened here. I think we've got three personalities in some ways coming through at the same time. Do you understand this?
Yeah.
Terry har beskrivit en ung man, men inte sagt att det är Malins son. Efter att ha fått veta att det rör sig om flera personer blir han osäker på vem han egentligen har haft kontakt med. Efter pausen fortsätter han sitt arbete. Terry har fått kontakt med en ung man som är kopplad till Malin. På vilket sätt är fortfarande oklart. Han menar att de är väldigt lika, och den unge mannen pratar mycket om sin mamma. Terry har alltså inte fått fram att det är Malins son han talar med. Inte heller har han fått någon kontakt med de två döttrarna. Och vi har bestämt att han ska få tre foton till hjälp.
Do you want to look at it?
That's the one I want to take. Then I want to take that one. Then I want to take that one. good looking guy.
He's really good looking, isn't he?
Yeah. That's a good looking guy. Mm. That's the man.
Yeah.
If I did this, these three were connected in some way.
Oh, yes.
I'll take a risk here. Were they all together when they passed?
Yes.
Thank you. We take this one. It's almost like... God, there's so much tragedy around this. There's so much sorrow. There's so much...
Yes.
She's not coming through. You won't recognize her telling me that her mum is still in this life.
Sorry?
Is her mum still in this life?
Yes.
Okay. Right. I haven't been over very long.
No.
Do you recognize this having anything to do with water?
Yes.
Thank you. What I had to deal with these three is that they were so traumatized when they weren't. Nothing to do with tsunami this, huh?
Yes.
Thank you. That's what they're telling me. They passed over in the tsunami.
Yes, they did.
It took time, I'm sorry, it took time, but there was so... What I was getting here was there was such an intensity when they came back. Do you understand?
Yes, I do.
It was so emotional. It's almost like you had a huge part of your family just wiped away.
Yes.
Do you understand?
Yes.
As the wave of the tsunami hit the beach. To the right of them, I don't know what you know, if anyone was with them that survived.
Ska jag tala om?
Was somebody there that survived?
Ja, var det. Alltså vi, jag var med dem. Jag är deras mamma.
So you were there? Okay.
Yeah, jag är mamma.
Okay, right, okay. Are these your children? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, but it's like, oh. That's why they were calling out. Okay, now I understand. Her hair was very important to her.
Yes, it was.
Her hair was very important to her. You know, it was like when she went to have a haircut, it was almost like they never knew what they were doing. Do you understand? She was a bit worried about going into the water because of her hair. So you this young thing still at school?
Sorry?
Was she still studying still at school?
Yes, she was.
Yeah. She would have gone all the way to university, that kid, if she'd worked hard.
Yeah, I know that.
She had a wonderful mind.
Yes.
She would have been really good at working in the medical profession one day.
Okay.
Do you understand?
Yeah, I understand.
She had a natural interest of the sciences or whatever, but she
yes.
was... Science was her thing, you know.
Yeah.
Science, mathematics.
Yeah, really,
yes
really
no.
bright.
And would you understand him telling me that you felt someone come close or touch your hair or pull your hair? A sensation of having someone come pulling your hair or touching your hair.
Yeah.
That's your son. But He will be stepping back. He will be... He's got to go on. He's got to move on. But he's not going to move on to desert you. Do you understand? He has to move on so you can move on. But I can tell you this, and I'll be really honest here, that the problem I had was there's such an intensity of emotion when they come through. It was almost impossible for them to talk.
It's like, yeah, I can understand that.
They're being called back now. They're being called back. But as they're being called back, know in your heart that they have found peace too, because they've been able to meet Mama today.
Yeah.
Well, you tell Mama that we're all fine and we didn't suffer. We didn't suffer.
Okay, Terry, what do you have to say about this reading with Malin?
The thing that I experienced all the way through the reading was confusion. Often when I've done readings in the past, if there are a lot of emotions, and this can block the medium.
But you felt blocked?
I felt blocked, yeah. I didn't feel my usual flow.
Why didn't you say so?
Looking back on it, I should have sort of just taken a pause and stepped back and done a check, but I didn't.
Have you learned anything from this?
Yes, I have. And that I'm not infallible. And I'm really pleased that the viewers can see this, because it a lot of people think that I can just sort of switch it on and turn it on 24 hours of the day and get any answers or information I need. So I'm glad that happened.
Berätta, hur upplevde du mötet med Terry?
Det var härligt att träffa Terry, för det har jag verkligen sett fram emot. Terry säger ju mycket som är Philip.
But he tells me you protected him for almost all his life.
Yeah, I did.
You protected him. You was almost like his second mama in one respect. You wasn't his mama, but you played the role of guardian.
Och sen säger han ju en del som inte jag riktigt kan få ihop med Philip, som det här med ölen och den biten. Jag vet ju att Philip drack öl när han var ute och festade och så, men det var inte så att han drack okontrollerat eller drack jämt och ständigt. Och en del andra saker som gardinerna och sådär.
Den här kvinnan som man talade om i början, vem var det?
Det var min mormor. Det visste jag direkt. När han beskrev hur hon såg ut och hennes personlighet, så visste jag direkt att det var mormor.
One's a woman.
Okay.
I don't know if she's a mother or a grandmother yet, but she's there, and she's very strong.
Okay.
But she's quite a happy lady. She's looking happy. She's wearing glasses, and she's just sitting there looking and looking at you. And she's been looking at you for quite some time. Do you understand?
Yeah.
And she's delighted to be here today.
Och det gör mig faktiskt glad, för jag tänker ofta på min mormor.
Det här med Emma, att hon skulle kunna bli vad som helst och vara intresserad av medicin.
Ja, det stämmer också jättebra. Hon hade ju de högsta betyg i skolan. Hon hade jättebra. Hon hade bara MVG och VG i allting. Och vi hade pratat om det här, att hon skulle eventuellt läsa till veterinär. För hon har en speciell känsla med djur.
She would have been really good at working in the medical profession one day.
Okay.
Do you understand?
Yeah, I understand.
She had a natural interest of the sciences or whatever, but science was her thing, you know.
Yeah.
Science, mathematics.
Yeah. Really, really bright.